Welcome to the module on understanding your blueprint. First of all, you're seeing this as a part of the blueprint explanation for your submission for the personally and socially responsible leadership section that you take in the 1 hour online course. We're going to begin by talking briefly about the blueprint itself. You're going to do it in three separate sections. The first time you'll do the blueprint will be in 201. And when you do that, what you'll be doing is you will be exploring your goals and interests at the university on how to expand yourself. Now, as you probably remember, there's a 60-hour requirement for the minor for you to expand your leadership development experiences the way you want to do that. And you're expected to do that in one of four parts, and we're going to talk about that later. But to begin to think about how to accomplish that, we want you in 201 to think about what you're interested in. Not just how to meet our expectations, but to really think about the university at large. So what will wind up happening is there are a bunch of opportunities for you to be thinking about different ways to get involved, then you'll type in your responses. At the end of that, you identify four or five things that you want to do that might be leadership experiences within those goals and interests, and then create a small table for yourself to be able to discuss how you will in the future pursue those opportunities that you're interested in, but that also give you the chance to expand your leadership skills. That's your 201 piece. You're also expected to start working with VolLinks. We're going to go over how to do that later in this program, but in VolLinks, you're collecting how you're going to be able to meet those 60 hours. You're also going to collect everything else you've done so that you can create a co-curricular transcript that can be available for anybody who is interested in what you've done in general at the university. So in addition to the academics and the transcript you can get from the registrar, we're going to be able to provide you with a co-curricular transcript that shows the rest of what you did here to make you as a holistic leader intellectually and leaderly. All right. So that's what you'll be doing through the VolLinks piece. When you're in VolLinks, that's the past. That's what's done. When you're in the blueprint, that's what you're going to do. That's the planned. So it's the future. All right? As far as your activities. The overall goal for you to do is, in addition to meeting this 60-hour requirement, you're also going to be able to demonstrate that you can learn how to improve your leadership skills for yourself to anyone who is aware of what you've done in the minor. Most importantly, it'll mean that you get to be the captain of your own ship for how you're going to develop yourself. To get you there, though, what's required of this course is the important piece, and it's the gap analysis. By the time you are taking this course, you should have completed, or are almost entirely complete, with all of the core content save the last class. This allows you to look at all of the leadership content that you've learned and assess where you are in that content. You're going to rate yourself on a scale of 1 to 5, and then once you've done that, you're also going to, in the notes section, say what that means for you and what you need to do to improve that to become the leader that you think you want to be, looking at all of the content across the curriculum. That's the gap analysis. Where you are, where you want to be, that's the gap. Okay? So in having done that across all the curriculum, then you'll, through the worksheets that are provided for the blueprint, you're going to continue to hone in on what you need to accomplish to be successful at helping yourself while here at this university do the things you're interested in, but to make them count for something, and intentionally make them count for something that makes you the person that you want to be when you finish here, the leader that you want to be. So ultimately, where we're headed with that is this gap analysis will then combine with your goals, and you'll create this planned future grid, shall we say, that will take you to the end of your career at the university. The last time you do it will be in 450 or 451, depending on how you take the course, and that's your post-college. What that calls for is you will do a new goals and interests, understanding what's available to you when you leave campus, a gap analysis that you've already completed, but to see where you are now before you leave campus, so that then you can identify how you spend the first 5 years or 3 years after you get out of the university developing your own leadership development. One of the things we promised you when you came here, and one of the things we promised academically when we got the program completed, was that our students would be able to manage their own leadership going forward, because you've got about a 50-year career in life that you're going to lead using what the university set you up for success. This shows that you can manage your own ship. You will be your own self-authored leader. So that's the big picture about the blueprint. What you're working on is this one, the gap analysis here. So let's talk about how to get that done in this class. You'll notice right here, this is where the assignment is, and that this assignment is actually due at 6:30 on March the 23rd. That's right after spring break. I want to also point out that if you're taking this class all online, everything's due. Now, for those of you watching this years in the future, it's due whenever it says it's due on this thing, okay? But for this class, this semester, all online students are due at, everything they've done to date is also due at this time, 6:30 at March the 23rd. Here's the button for the submitting it and submitting your assignment, and here's how I'm gonna grade it, okay? Let's hit the button and see what happens. You'll notice that you have available to you the template that you're going to fill out for the blueprint. I'm going to open that up in a minute. But we've also provided you with an example of how to fill out that gap analysis. If you haven't ever heard of Harry Potter, this still you can get the general gist from it. But it's about a young Dumbledore creating his blueprint gap analysis for how he wanted to become the Dumbledore that we read about in Harry Potter books. Dumbledore was the old guy who wound up being kind of like me, I would like to say, for the program. That said, that is an example for how to fill that out, so you can get a vision of that. In addition to that, we provided you with these three links because these will help you with what you're trying to do here. Because what you're going to do is when you submit that grid that's a part of this, you're going to be able to show that you're going to have met the requirements of a minor by having finalized that. So you do need to think about it, and if you can't remember them, they're right there. In addition to that, if you want some ideas of field experiences to allow you to get that, there's a chart here. These are not the only ones permitted, just to be clear, but they're ideas. And what we're doing is we're building that up based on the ideas you're giving us when you submit these things to show us what you've actually thought match these goals. These will be approved as you go, and this is how you submit them. To be able to do when we set over here, the Vol Links, the past, when you complete an activity, you need to go to Vol Links and record your experience. So real quick, we're going to show you what all this stuff looks like. Not going to go through it entirely, because I don't think that you could even imagine what we're doing. But just as a reminder, you've seen this already, here is the form that talks about the requirements. You have to get something in three of these four categories: an academic experience, a service and social responsibility, so your service experience, a multicultural or intercultural experience, and a student leadership experience. No more than 12 hours in any one. So the point is that we want to have at least five experiences. Even if you had 15 or 20 hours, you're only going to count 12 towards these requirements. But you're going to write it in on the other so that we know how much time you've actually committed to doing these activities. And at least three of the four. So that's the requirements that you're required to do. So this is your gap analysis template. You'll notice that there's a lot of information here. If it were me, print this out and put it beside you, and then move to the part that's the actual template. This will allow you to know how to walk through what's expected of you. That's all there is to it. I think it's actually pretty self-explanatory, but if it's not, then go back to the step that's associated with it. I almost don't think it's worth your while to read every inch of it, because you'll then get confused before you actually get started. If it were me, I'd start here. Okay? You're going to put in your va-va-voom. If you haven't already done a va-va-voom, you can find it online. We'll have it there. But this is where you sit down and you identify what your vision is, what your values are, and what your mission is. You're continuing to hone that every semester. The one that you did the past semesters, pull it out and rework it. Don't start from scratch. You don't have to do that. Just pull it out and keep going. And be who you are today and what matters to you today. And continue to hone it there. And then put it right there. Then, everything that you did for 201, go cut and paste and put that right there. So, a hint, you could open what you submitted in 201 and then just keep going if you wished. So either you're going to plug this into there or it into there. Either way, your deal. Then this is the grid where you talk about your collegiate plans. Okay? And that's where you say, I'm going to do this to be able to accomplish that. And this is why I'm choosing to do it and how it helps me achieve the goals that I want to do. That way you can be intentional. That's the last thing you're going to do. But to get there, these are the worksheets you'll be doing in class for this work. And you will notice that these were homeworks. So you've already been assigned to do these. So you should have already started them. Pull the homework out. Yes, I did just trip on a table. Pull the homework out, and as I said, 1 to 5, and in what ways they need to be developed. This is everything content-wise that you should have learned in the minor by now, or should be able to go back and update. Once you've gone through everything in the minor, then, I'm still doing the stuff you should have learned in the minor. If you want to ever be able to identify what I expect of you and what faculty expect of you in these courses, this is a helpful grid for everything. Then here, once you've identified that, then your goal is to come to Appendix 2, and this is where you start identifying your priorities. Now, I've given you 8 boxes. If your priorities are more than that you want to be working on, it's your call. But I really think it's a good idea for you to hone in on some key things that you know you're going to move the needle on while you're in the minor and you're finishing your time at UTK. That's the point of this. To identify what are these practices or actions that need work and include an example of the deficit so you remember what you're talking about and I can understand what you're talking about. Again, rate yourself from low to high, 1 to 5. And then in what way do I need to improve? So that you can become very concrete on what this means. That's Appendix 2. Okay? Very straightforward. Appendix 3, the whole point of this is now that I know these are things I need to do, how can I work on this over the remainder of my time here? So where can I get the exposure to new learning about those things? What can I do to reinforce what I already know about them? And how can I accelerate my learning? 3 basic questions about the things you think matter. Then answer, where can you do it in UTK, in your future industry or job or country, a company, or a civil or social connection you have. Thinking about 3 things that will help you fix the work that we just discussed as priorities and what's available to you. What is your capital that you're not recognizing? Or that you already did recognize, I'm just asking you to prove you know it to me. And last but not least, here, your co-curricular transcript. Once you finish those things and you see what you've already done, once you've finished those other 3 appendix that help you think about what matters and what you need to work on, then you come back up and you complete your grid for your plan. Just to be clear, the first semester, so spring 2017, here, what are the activities? And it's not just 2, it's as many as you think are necessary. Which office you're doing it with, is there a leadership possibility in that office, and what's it going to do to help you? Summer 2017, whatever you're working on, the same. Fall 2017, spring 2018. Fill this bad boy out until you graduate. And do as many as you think you need to so that you can determine how to move from where you are today and use everything this institution has to help you be as successful as you humanly possibly can, because you're spending an awful lot of time and money to be here. If you're going to invest in yourself, do it wisely. That's the goal. So that's what the blueprint is. I am going to make you aware of one last piece, and that's the vol links. Now, there's already in the orientation video under the Leadership Studies minor a video on, not a video, but a PowerPoint on how to sign up for these. I think we have that actually linked to this site to make things easier for you. But just for the heck of it, let me show you how straightforward this is. Vol links, I type it in, UTK. If I can't remember what the link is, I just type that in. The first thing that opens up is your vol link. So hit it and it'll load up eventually. Okay. Come over here to the little sign up sign, and when you press that, what you're going to notice is that it comes to Karen, for me, whatever your name is. Press on that same thing again, you'll see this list. Press on involvement. When you do that, it will open to this screen. On this screen, there are two things that matter to you. Well, three things, actually, if you haven't done 201. But at this juncture, there are two things. There's experiences and this co-curricular transcript. Okay. So I mentioned if you haven't done your 201 yet, and I'll go ahead and share this just so in case you haven't thought through it, or you maybe didn't realize there's some things you needed to work on, and now you do, and you need to figure out what's available. Under interests, this is all of the information that the university has for the different organizations and activities. This is a good place for you to start exploring some of those things you may not have considered yet. So that's one. Two, under experiences, you will notice once you've hit experiences that you're able to add an experience. And once you do that, you'll notice that here are your four categories. Press the one that you think the experience you want to load up most meets, and when you do, it will open a screen like this one. Okay? That vaguely explains what it's doing and what we're in some examples. And then you put your experience name in. You put your organization name that it's associated with, the start date and the end date, and the number of hours. This is the total number of hours that requires. Then, in the reflection, you're going to put the number of hours that you wish for this to count towards the minor. Okay, so this is going to be the actual total number of hours, but down here, you're going to put the number of hours that this thing is counting towards the 60 hours that's the requirement. And you're going to put the rest of your reflection. Just basically how you think about how this works and all the questions I just asked you. How does this activity forward your goals, and did it meet your expectations and what you need to do given that you have finished it now? Then you put the contact name in, the contact title, contact phone number, the contact email. If there's a website, you do that, and then anything else you think that's important. If there's a file that you need to upload with it, that's even better. The bottom line is then you submit this darn thing. And we verify it, and then when it comes time for you to graduate, you're able to say, I have 60 hours that are coached because this blueprint coaches you, and that they are verified because this vol links thing verifies you. That isn't happening many other places in the country, the two things together. That's the key. And the way to submit is right there. That's the vol links. Last but not least, I will point out to you that you need to also upload this content before you submit your portfolio. And I thought I would just point out to you where that would be. So where that is again in Canvas. Your portfolio will be underneath that little dot, and at the bottom where it says ePortfolio, you can have multiple portfolios, but only one leadership studies portfolio. And under that, you will notice that here in the left-hand side, two things of importance. One, remember I talked about those coached hours. You're going to put your co-curricular transcript, the final one, here when you're submitting. And if you were in a position where you're sharing this with an employer, they're going to be able to know, A, that you did these hours, B, what you did and learned from those hours, and C, that we verified that it in fact is true. The other thing to be aware of is right here. This is this class. You'll open up this page, and for this page, either, depending on how it works, sometimes it's on that far right-hand side, and other times it's on the bottom. In this case, it's on the bottom. It just depends on how wide your view is. And in that, you will submit your blueprint on this site here. And that's where your blueprint will reside for this course. Okay? That's how this will all be shared for the future for you. This is my desktop. It is indicative of what my life is like. I appreciate your time. Have a wonderful night. And don't hesitate to contact me or the Leadership Study Advisors, the Advisory Board members, because they're here for you. And see you soon.